Hello everybody, my name is Patrick Outeny and welcome in another YouTube chess training video. And today I will speak about Hori e4 d5 and when white will take on d5 is coming knight to c3. And next video we will see when black is going to d6. Now we will speak about black is going to a5. I believe that the best move is d4. And now it's good to remember that move e5 is not good anymore, and I will show variation why. e5, when black is playing e5, only what you need to remember is to play with all your minor pieces and going for fast short castle. So knight to f3, if black will take on d4, you will take on d4, you have advantage in time because you have two minor pieces on a game, and yes, it's not difficult to play this position, not theory, but simple chess. If black is going bishop to g4, it's good to remember that every time if you will be first in castling, first in development, you will play good chess. So you're playing this simple chess, and then now you can take on e5. You have extra pawn. For this reason, black will need to take on e2, and it's good to remember a move to h5. h5 has a really strong threat because you can play check, then you can play check, and you can win on a5. A really good game, and for this reason, black need to be careful about check on f5, and maybe black should play rook to d7. We are playing rook to e1, and you can see that black is weak on the last rank, and still his difficulties. For example, if black will take here, you can take here on f7, and you can understand that it's lost because it's checkmate on e8. For this reason, this threat is really strong, and move to h5 is the best move in this position. If you will know this maneuver, you can win a lot of good games. For this reason, the best move is knight to e6, and after rook to e1, it's really difficult for black to save f7 pawn. For example, if you're going to b4, we can take on f7 with extra material. So don't worry about this, it's not so important. Important is to play d4, and we know that move e5 is not strong anymore. And for this reason, we are going to main variation. Here, black should play bishop to g4, and this move is not a really good move because we are playing h3. Yes, if black will take, we have two bishops and advantage in time, so don't worry a lot. And after bishop to h5, g4, knight to e5, we will play like a run for the bishop to g6, and we can play h4, h5, and for black it's really difficult to save this material. Maybe here we can play h5 with nearly winning game, because it looks like black doesn't losing material. It does not losing material, but we have advantage in space. We have strong moves like h6, and to g5, to g4, attack f7. We have strong bishop on g2, which should be really strong on this diagonal. Long castle, huge advantage for white. So this is nearly dreaming position for white in this opening, and we are coming back for this position. Then black should play knight to c6. He's planning bishop to g4 and a long castle. Good to remember is bishop to d4, and after bishop to g4, everything is straightforward, and you have to remember knight to b5. Of course, only one move is going to b6, and remember move c4, not a4, but c4 is really the best move because c5 is really big threat, and black need to take on f3. You will take with baby, black will take on d4, everything is coming really with time, and after check check. We have endgame where we have two bishops, really good pawn structure and advantage. And when black has two pawns and we have three pawns on the left side of the chessboard, really this is advantage for white. So don't worry about this variation, and we can go back for variation c6. And in this variation we are playing bishop to c4 and we are waiting to move e6. It's really important to understand that we are waiting for move e6. Black need to go the first with bishop, because to play now e6 is a really bad idea for black, because bishop is locked behind his pawns and that's not a good idea. For this reason, black should play to g4 or to f5, and I will show firstly bishop to g4, we are playing h3, bishop to d2, and still we are waiting for move e6. And it's nearly same like in our main variation, where we will play knight to d5, of course is attack on a5, and then we should play that we will take on f6. When black will go to d8, we will take on f6, and we are nearly in the same position, and it's not a big difference if the bishop is on h5 or on f5. That's good to understand that we don't need to learn so many theory. So here, if black will take with g-pawn, we are playing g4, and with advantage in plan h4, h5, we should know that black has bad pawn structure, so nearly every ending will be favor for white. If black will take with baby on f6, we are playing g4, and a strong move is going to e2. Black will not take on c2 because it's a really strong attack, and I believe maybe bishop to f4. It's difficult for black this position in this variation. It looks like black is nearly lost, like here. So, but I'm coming back for main variation, where black is playing bishop to f5, and as I told you, we are waiting for move a6. So for this reason, we are playing bishop to d2, and it's no reason why black will wait with move e6. And now we are playing our main move, knight to d5. And after knight to d5, we wish to take knight on f6. And it's good to know these two basic plans. If we will take with knight and black will take with g-pawn, that's not a really good move. Our main plan is to go knight to h4, to take bishop on g6, play h4, g4, h5, and has a really strong pawn structure. I will show everything. For example, we are playing c4, knight to d7, we are playing the standard moves like nearly every time, and now is our main plan going h4, and we can take or we can play long castle, and we are playing h4 with idea g4 and h5. And then, of course, we have simple plan to play h5, h6, h7, and you know, we are with position with two bishops with simple plan, and it's important that we know what to play. So for this reason, the better idea is to take by baby on f6. Yes, we are playing baby to e2, and we are not worried if black will take on c2. This is too risky. We can play d5, and you can see that the Rolling Stones is rolling or are rolling, because this is a difficult position for black. Maybe black will take on b2, but we are going for a short castle, and I don't believe that black will survive this position. So I probably nobody will take on c2, and everybody will play bishop to d7, knight to d7, yes, long castle. Now the Bad move is going bishop to d6 because you are playing bishop to g5, is good to remember. And now d5. In this opening, it's a really strong move, d5. And if you can play d5, just play d5, because this is really strong. Maybe if black will take with c-pawn, you will take with rook. And it's a difficult position. You can see that it's open position. You are in advantage of time. You have playing aggressive moves, and black need to survive opening, so don't worry too much. And the best move is knight to b6. You can play not bad move bishop to d3, and with small advantage, for example, when black will take, you will take. And yes, it's not huge advantage, but you have square on e5, so you can play rook to e1, knight to e5, bishop to c3, maybe c4, and you know, this is a simple position with small advantage. But if you wish to have more, so after knight to b6, you should remember this really amazing idea, bishop to g5. This is amazing because check with me this variation, and if you will remember or learn this variation, you can beat nearly anybody in the world. h4, of course, threat is h5, so black should play h6, and you can play now knight to a5, and you can see that it's difficult for black to stay with baby on h7. Now remember a really amazing idea, d5. d5 is like everything is under fire, and this is mess. This is a really messy position, and believe me, nobody will be happy to play this position from black side. So it's a really mad idea. What black should do? Black should take on c4, but we will take on c4. Black will not take on g5 because we will take on c6, and white is winning. Believe me or not, this is really lost for black. So yes, don't worry too much. So once again, we will take, and maybe black will take on d5, and we are going to b3 with threat to take on b7. It's difficult to save the square, because if black going to b8, we will take on c6. You can see that really it's strong attack. So the best move is going to c8, and we're going to rook to e1, and the engine is +5 for white. So yes, looks like okay. So after d5, black should take on g5, and we will take on e6 again. A really big mess position, and believe me, nobody will play this position with you twice. So black should take with bishop. It's really bad because you will take on f7, and you know, if black will take with like this, is checkmate, and you are famous because you play game of your life. So maybe black will take with f-pawn, and then still is strong attack after g4, and yes, should take on c2, but we will take on e6, and even here, I don't believe that you will you will understand that black is lost. I believe that you will be on my side, that this position is really bad for black. So maybe after g6 to f3, and for example, nearly winning is check on f7 to take g6 is check, and now we can play check on f5, and we can win something like that, h5, and this position is really strong for white with big advantage. So I spoke about really interesting moves in this opening. It's good to remember that our main time or main idea of this opening is wait for move a6. and then playing knight to d5 and to take on f6. The best move is to take with baby, and it's up to you after move to e2 if you will play now bishop to d3, or if you will try to play really aggressive moves with strong attack, and maybe you can try to play this variation, because this variation is really interesting and it's hard to play for black. If you don't want to play bishop to g5, you can play bishop to d3, or bishop to b3 maybe is interesting, and yes, still a good position for white. That's everything what I wish to tell you in this variation. In next video we will speak about variation when black is going to d6, and I hope you will enjoy this video as well. Thank you very much for watching, and I hope I will see you soon in our chess YouTube video. Thank you for every like, dislike, or if you will follow us, I will be very happy. Thank you very much and see you soon. Bye bye.